La prima volta che ho visto questa barca, ho pensato, è meravigliosa.
The first time I saw this boat, I thought, it's wonderful. Then I started to study it to understand how it is built. I saw where they installed the propulsion system, and I realized that this is an extraordinary boat. This is Palm Beach GT60, and this, in the background, is Miami. I find it has a refined style, no strangeness, no excess. The design is graceful, appealing, elegant, sensual, charming. This, certainly thanks to the line of the hull and the shape of the deckhouse and its windshield, a single piece of crystal with double curvature. I enjoy this space in the bow where you can overlook the sea. The sun deck, it is only one for two people, but when you lie down here with your partner, you don't really want anyone else, do you? The anchor leaves the well with a very precise automated system. On the sides, electric windows, which I've never seen so wide on a boat of this size. Aft, the classic opening window that joins the living room, the cockpit, and outside a kitchen area that allows you to prepare all meals without needing to go below deck in the other kitchen. In the architecture of this model, you find a modern style as well as a traditional essence of boating. I can't stand anyone who wants to turn boats into a home. This is my aesthetic taste, and I'm falling in love with this brand. In the lounge, look at the arrangement of the furnishings, but concentrate your attention above all on the details, all beautiful. Teak-shaped and smoothed by silked hands, the furniture has been designed for comfort. To satisfy the aesthetic taste, and as far as security, there are no sharp edges. Palm Beach offers the possibility to customize the furniture as well as the layout, but be careful. Think carefully before changing something because it would be a shame to spoil this beauty. Going down on the lower deck, you immediately come across the kitchen, which also serves as a hallway to the two cabins. It receives light from above and from the side. It has many cabinets, and if you are looking for the washing machine, here it is. There are only two cabins on this 60 feet, at least on this model. Tell me which one you prefer of the two. I'm undecided because the one at the top receives light from the skylight. It has a wardrobe, four drawers under the bed and under the makeup area, and cabinets along the sides. Almost in the center of the boat, there is the other one, the real owner cabin with the headbed on the side, two bedside tables, the beauty area, the large wardrobe with mirrored doors. In short, both cabins are very comfortable and have an ensuite bathroom with a shower. Let's go down to the engine room.
It
is as if they have built the boat around the engines, which are at the center of the hull and are connected to the IPS pod drives, which are located at the stern with carbon joints. This solution is the basis of the stability features, but also of the dynamism of this yacht. The hull, the deck, and the deckhouse are so light that they do not affect the position of the center of gravity as heavily as on other boats.
Guardate anche I dettagli di questa sala macchine.
Also, look at the details of this engine room. fuel lines, double filters held with double nuts. It's perfect. Its line and interiors are the result of a beautiful project, excellent in both terms of aesthetics and functionality. But we are here to test it.
Il Palm Beach GT60 che proviamo oggi.
The Palm Beach GT60 we are testing today was equipped with two 1,000 horsepower Volvo Penta engines, combined with the Pod Drive IPS propulsion, and the whole system is called IPS 1350.
Abbiamo lasciato Miami downtown.
We left downtown Miami behind us and are headed offshore.
Sono diversi I motivi che ci permettono.
There are several reasons that allow us to indicate this boat somewhat special.
Intanto la costruzione è realizzata per infusione di resina vinil ester e fibre di vetro.
For starters, the construction. It's made by infusion of vinyl ester resin, glass fibers and vacuum packed, and with a sandwich type structure, this as regards to the hull. This gives it lightness and sturdiness. The deck and deck house are made of carbon.
Abbiamo visto come hanno installato I motori a centro scafo.
We have seen how they installed the engines at the center of the hull. This serves to give the boat longitudinal stability, to make the pitch less evident.
E poi tutti I pesi, perché la tuga è leggera, sono concentrati.
And because the deckhouse is light, all the weights are concentrated in the lower part, at least all the important weights. And this should also give us good static and dynamic stability. In fact, when we were shooting our images, we realized how solid it is, although it has no gyroscopic stabilizer installed. It doesn't need it. But now let's take it out on the waters. I hadn't realized I was already planing, partly because the boat is very quiet, partly because it takes just a few engine revs to bring the boat into planing trim. So now let me cut down the gas, so I can tell you when it enters planing.
Ci siamo.
Here we are, just over 10 knots. Engines at just 950 RPM.
Straordinario. In questo momento, l'angolo.
At this moment, the angle of incidence of the hull on the surface is 4 degrees, which is also ideal for navigating quickly.
Volevo soffermarmi ad andature basse per darvi qualche dato di consumo.
I wanted to stop at low speeds to give you some consumption data, but this boat wants to run. We are already at 20 knots and we are consuming less than 100 liters per hour.
Anzi, il dato ora si è stabilizzato, sono.
Actually, the data has now stabilized, 77 liters per hour at 20 knots.
Quando lo yacht ha il baricentro in basso, ti permette.
When the yacht has the center of gravity at the bottom, it allows you to turn in a very simple way, without an excessive heeling angle. And the inertia that the hull assumes due to the effect of the kinetic energy when I go to set up a counterturn practically does not exist.
Unite tutto questo all'agilità delle propulsioni.
Combine all this agility of the IPS propulsion, and you find yourself in the hands of a 60-foot-long boat, which is very sharp. Look, look at this 20 knots turn. I feel great pleasure in navigating on an easy to drive boat.
Hanno fatto un eccellente lavoro nel disegnare le linee d'acqua di questo.
They did an excellent job of drawing the water lines of this hull, because I went into a turn at 20 knots and went out at 19.7 knots. How is it possible that during a turn you don't lose speed? At this speed of 1,600 RPM, the engines are very aggressive. It is also thanks to the lightness of the hull and the way of navigating with little hydrodynamic resistance. A low hydrodynamic resistance brings us to 30 knots at 1,850 RPM.
con un consumo totale che è...
with a total consumption of around 190 liters per hour.
L'angolo di corsa dello scafo continua a essere...
the running angle of the boat continues to be perfect, the 5 degrees.
Siamo alla massima velocità di crociera.
We are at maximum cruising speed. Engines are at 2100 RPM. Speed 36 knots. Consumption is 260 liters per hour. Navigating this fast with a full tank of fuel, we can travel 400 miles non-stop.
Sento così bene.
I feel it navigating so well that I just need to push the throttle down.
Sento volare sull'acqua ed è una condizione strana.
I can sense it flying over the water, and it's a strange thing to feel a 60 foot so light, so sharp at 42 knots of maximum speed.
Il cantiere dichiara di voler costruire imbarcazioni perfette per i suoi armatori.
The shipyard declares that it wants to build perfect boats for its owners. I don't know if this boat is ideal, because it all depends on the taste and wishes of the owner. But I must tell you that the sensations experienced on board really come close to perfection.